Good morning.
Good morning. How's everyone today?
Yes. Welcome to our Facebook Live for the sewing workshop. Although you may not recognize us because we are not Linda, decidedly.
No. If you hadn't figured it out yet, we are not Linda.
We are not. I'm Betsy. This is Erin. You have probably emailed or called us or talked to us somehow. But Linda is off today. She's playing hooky. She is in Tennessee.
Yes, at Shake Rag, taking painting classes.
Taking painting classes. So we finally let her go have a vacation.
I think she said it's been 2 years before she left. Oh. I was like, whew, get out the door.
Yeah.
There was some disagreement from Alex back here, but no. Yes, everybody deserves a vacation. So we are here to do your Facebook Live today.
Yeah, the inmates have taken over the asylum, if you will.
<It's Newman. laughs>
But what we're going to talk about today is linen. Beautiful, cool, breezy linen. Yes. We love it.
Yes.
We're wearing it because it's hot. Yes. And yeah, so that's what we're going to talk about. Now, I have some linen facts.
Okay.
Which I had to write down. So, a few things about linen, which you should know, is that all linen is made from the flax plant. So, if you find a linen, and it's called linen, and it might look like it, but it's not made out of flax, that's just a fake.
Linen-like. Sometimes you see that.
Yes, sometimes you see linen-like, because sometimes you'll get like that slubby texture on something, but true linen is from the flax plant, which is a beautiful little blue floral plant. And it is a great plant because it is super sustainable. It takes a lot less water than cotton does. Let me see. I have a quote that a linen shirt uses 6.4 liters of water, a cotton shirt 2,700 liters.
Wow, that's quite a difference.
Water. Yes, so that's a big difference. So it's sustainable in many ways. It has been around since time began. The Egyptians used it as currency.
Wow.
That's how much they liked linen.
Well, we have quite the currency here
we do.
On our wall.
We are wealthy, wealthy people. But we like it because it's lightweight, it's cool. It's actually moisture wicking, so in the summer it will suck up your sweat, if you will, and let the air circulate around you. But it is also kind of heat retentive, so you can wear it in the winter. Like, often I'll do like a sweater and linen pants.
Nice, because it breathes no matter if it's cold
breathes,
or whether
it's
warm.
So right. I think you genuinely think of it as summer, but you can really wear it year round. So those are a little bit of linen facts. Oh, easily washed. But it does do some shrinking. However, a lot of the linen that we have is pre-washed.
Yes, yes, we do have quite a few colors of washed linen.
Yes, but we do always recommend you cut your little 4-inch square and you pop it in laundry first.
Mm-hmm. Right.
Because pre-washed or not, nobody wants a too small shirt after they've taken the time to cut it out and sew it.
Says Betsy.
Says me. The voice of experience.
Yes, and I think with linen, it's nice to pre-wash it. I think it softens it up a little bit. And also, as you're working with it during your project, it softens it up. And I think it gives it that really nice feel when you're wearing it.
Right. And I think linen, sometimes you see it on the bolt, and it seems not like stiffer, but not quite as soft as like a cotton. And so maybe you go for cotton. But linen, the more you wash it, like, it just gets softer and more pliable and crumpled and
drapey.
It feels so nice. Whereas I think sometimes the more you wash cotton, it can start to look tired, like sometimes, but linen, it looks better. It better with age.
It's always a good trait.
Yes. Yeah, thank you, Alex. Alex said just like us.
But moving on from the age.
Because we're getting so we've each pulled inspiration for what we want for our linen wardrobes for the summer. And we're going to share that with you today.
Right, because it's been very hot here, 100 degrees. So these cool, easy breezy linen garments and ensembles are just what we need.
Yes, exactly. So I'm going to kick it off. A couple times a year, I find myself going back into my archives of books and magazines and looking to see what's in there. What do I feel like? And I found myself looking at some of my Isaac Mizrahi books and magazines. And he is a designer now. He's on QVC quite a bit, but in the 90s he had his whole collection and the high-end designer. So, to me, what Isaac is color. I think of him as the king of color, and particularly orange and pink. So I pulled some images. Alex, can you see that? So that's a good one. I love the combination of orange and pink.
So very nice. See,
very mm-hmm. nice. And as I was looking through my little magazines and books of his work, it just kept popping up. So we've got a really fabulous little pink jacket, pink and yellow, can't go wrong. And so these hot summer pink and orange and yellow colors were really what was calling to me. So I decided to make something I've never made before, which is the 1111 skirt.
Very cute.
Thank you. So I kind of think of it as my sunset skirt, because I feel like a sunset in it. Now, the 1111 on the pattern cover, if you look at the drawing, it goes to like a T length, mm-hmm. I would say.
Right.
Is it T length?
Right.
That's not a good length for me. I'm very short. Even with heels on, standing next to Aaron, you can see that there's a decided difference. So I ended up shortening my skirt 8 inches.
Wow.
It was a lot.
I like the length, though, on you.
Thanks.
I think that's great.
Thanks. Mm-hmm. You know, it's short enough for me, but like long enough that you don't have to worry about wind sitting down. So this is a good length for me. And otherwise, I made it pretty much out of the package, just as it is. But I did do one change, which is in the pattern, you button this mm-hmm. to the side.
Right.
And when I was trying it on, looking in the mirror, and trying to decide where to put the button, I kind of just liked it loose.
Just dropped it
just
and decided
it
that was
and decided
a good
loose.
Look.
I like the movement that it gives. It gives a little movement. Mm-hmm. And I think it actually, it draws the eye down. So I'm pretending that it makes me look taller. I don't know if that's the case. But, you know, hope springs eternal, right?
And I love how it shows how drapey the linen is.
It does, yeah. Mm-hmm. So this is some of our pre-washed linen. And then I also washed it. So it is, mm-hmm. it's already softened because I washed it. So, yeah, it has
a beautiful.
Nice drape.
And, of course, you had the heels to match.
I did. I just happened to have some chartreuse high heels,
of course,
in the closet. The other thing I made to go with it, because as much as I love a solid bottom, I have to have a print on top. I just can't help it. So I did it's a mix-it shirt with a Eureka neckline.
I think that's brilliant. I mean, I keep thinking about spring and summer tops. I want something easy to make, mm-hmm. you know, that doesn't take a long time to make, and you could do woven. And
yeah.
I had not thought of that. I love it.
Yeah. And I consider doing the Eureka, but we don't have one on the wall. The Eureka is actually, it's a pretty boxy shirt. And I felt like the proportion for this skirt needed something slightly mm-hmm. closer form-fitting. I mean, not
so.
Form-fitting, but closer.
Right. With the cottons, I think that's a good choice to have it a little bit
mm-hmm.
more form-fitting.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah. And this is a Tantalon Liberty Cotton.
Of course.
My favorite. it was an easy switch. I really just layered the Eureka pattern on top of the mix-it and traced the collar.
Nice.
It was easy.
Easy peasy.
Yes.
Nice.
So that was my first inspirational ensemble. But then we all know that I love a dress.
Yes.
I'm not much of a pant wearer. So let me drag this lady over. Mm-hmm.
I know, I think I've seen you in a pants a couple times.
A couple times.
Yes, those beautiful Tahoe pants are unforgettable.
I do love my Tahoe mm-hmm. pants, but it looks like a skirt, so I feel more comfortable. So this, I realize on the mannequin, it looks like a shirt, but I assure you that on me, this is long enough for a dress.
Yes.
It's the same pre-washed linen, and mm-hmm. what it is it's the splice shirt that I've lengthened into a dress.
That would be a crop top on me, I think. No.
I know.
Teasing, but.
I think it's knee length on me.
Knee
like,
length.
I think it's pretty mm-hmm. long. And then mm-hmm. I used a print on the side and on the splice just to add a little.
Mm-hmm. I like that.
A little something.
A little pop.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. So I'm excited about that. And I have to say that a couple weekends ago, I was working out in the yard. It was roughly 1 million degrees. I came inside, and I got cleaned up, and we were going to go out, and I just threw on that linen dress. Oh, my God. It was, like, so cool and comfortable.
Nice.
And
easy to throw on.
I mm-hmm. didn't really want to mm-hmm. put anything else on except
right.
a shifty linen dress.
That's what's nice about dresses this time of year is it's one piece. One and done.
Mm-hmm.
You just throw it on. It's easy. Throw on sandals, maybe a necklace, or not, because sometimes it's way too hot for necklaces and jewelry.
That's true. too much.
Right. So, but it's easy, you know? And it's when it's that hot.
Yeah.
And need something.
The splice, I think, particularly makes a nice shift, because it's not form-fitting, but it does have shape to it, so it's not mm-hmm. just like a big box. So I really like it.
Nice.
In fact, I brought one that I had made previously, and some of you who were able to come to our workshop in February of 2020, we had a workshop with Sarah Campbell, and we worked on fabric painting.
Yes, that was an amazing workshop.
It was so much fun, and I did a splice dress there as well.
Oh, I remember
that I did pineapples on.
That is you, right there.
It is all stripe, all pineapple.
Mm-hmm.
And I wore this the other day to a new restaurant that was like all tropical decorated. And they were like, oh my God. I was like, I'm on brand.
Was it a tiki bar?
It was actually a tiki coffee place.
Oh my goodness.
Oh, yeah.
They made that with you in mind,
I know.
Betsy loves a good tiki bar.
I do. So the other thing is, although I don't wear pants very much, I do probably have a pair of West End pants on at some point every day, because they are my like at home wear.
Mm. Comfy.
Comfy.
Right. Mm-hmm.
I made this pair of linen West End pants in August. They have now been washed so much they're so super soft.
Oh my gosh.
Super soft.
Yes.
And I put in a little detail in the back. Same with the pockets and the waistband, just for fun. But I have two pair of these, and I just put them with whatever little print top I feel like putting on.
Nice.
And then I can be around the house and not look like I'm in scruffy jeans or pajamas all the time.
You feel like you're in pajamas because they're so comfortable.
Yes.
But yes, you're.
Yes.
You've raised the bar.
Because it was looking a little rough there for a while. But the West End pants out of linen have really saved my at-home wear.
Nice.
For sure. So that is my linen wardrobe. Oh, sure. Alex asked for me to go through the patterns again. This is the 1111 skirt. The mix-it top with the Eureka neckline, the splice shirt that's been lengthened into a dress. Oh, the fabric on the sleeve, unfortunately we're out of it.
Mm.
I think we maybe have one end cut and you guys can battle over that. But it is a viscose polyester. And the pineapple dress. The pineapple dress is also a splice, a lengthened splice, but I did it sleeveless.
This is very true.
Well,
yes, Betsy would never look scruffy.
The West End pants came because I had too many pajama pants with holes in it, and I was like, this is it. I got to clean myself up. Too much. So
I like it. Very fun.
Yeah.
Bright, vibrant.
Yeah.
I like that.
And cool. Mm-hmm. And yeah, I like it too.
Okay.
All right. So we're going to do a quick switcheroo, and Alex is going to come on, and she and Aaron are going to tell you about their stuff.
All right.
Yeah,
sounds good. Thanks, Betsy.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, Alex and I are going to do the next set. So I know my inspiration for summer is a lot of solid linens. I love white. I love bold colors. So I'm going to start with my love of white here with some inspiration. So I think everybody needs a good white shirt, a good white dress. It's just like we're talking about with Betsy. It's just easy to throw on. It looks crisp and fresh.
You're getting a lot of comments about your dress, so people really want to hear it.
Oh,
I love it.
Good.
So hold on, guys. It's coming soon.
Okay, so this is one of the inspirations I had. I also love hats in the summer. And so just this beautiful white dress, simple, and of course it looks like she's, I don't know, entertaining or something, which I also love to do. So just easy white linen dresses. And so what I have on is the Memphis. So I did a combination of white French terry with linen, like white linen, and I shortened the sleeves, and I also lengthened it. So I just took the bottom bands, the front and back bottom bands, and I lengthened them 5 inches. Of course, you could lengthen them however many inches that you would need to make it a full-length dress, but for me, it was 5 inches. But it's just very breezy, very light, and it worked out really well combining the knit and the linen together. You could do the combination however you want. I did knit on the sleeves. I did knit for the front pieces. And then I did linen for the drape, and then linen for the bands. And then on the back, I have one, I can't remember which one. Wait, this one. This one's knit here on the right back, and then the left back is the linen. So, but you could really combine it however you want. I did go up a size because I wanted it to be a little looser. I don't want something like hugging my body this time of year. So I went up a size, and I think that could also accommodate doing linen on the whole dress.
Mm-hmm. So. And I've even made this without the bottom band, which would be fun too. Like if you wanted it shorter and you wanted like a tunic type of thing that's white, you just eliminate that bottom band and you have this like really cool asymmetrical tunic. So that's another way to think about it.
Right, and I love this pattern. I know, you know, it has this great drape, which I think, you know, you just let it fall, and I think it's really flattering. You know, I think it's a pretty slimming dress, actually.
Mm-hmm. You look great in it.
So, thank you.
I'm gonna get this hair off.
Oh no!
Off of it.
Yes.
Yeah.
I think a lot of white linen dresses are really popular right now, and so I knew that I could make one myself. So I held back from buying all the dresses. And made one of myself. So.
It's like when you see a trend so strong, which is what we're seeing with linen right now. I mean, like what Betsy said, it has so many, like it's sustainable, it's all these things. And I saw in an article from Harper's Bazaar, like linen is the 2021 trend. It's risen like 102% right now. And even brands that have never used linen before are starting to use it, like higher end brands like Fendi and Dior. So there is something about like the timelessness of linen. We think of it for the summer because of course when it's hot, we don't want to feel sweaty or sticky or have our clothes stick to us. Yeah, but even like because of that temperature effect linen has, you can wear it all season long in winter, anytime. So.
Right, and it's actually really nice to travel with. I know it wrinkles, but I think go with it. Roll with the fact that it wrinkles and it has a natural fiber, and just let it be what it is, and you'll stay nice and cool. So
yeah.
I really like it.
Are there any other inspirations you got for us?
I do. And so summer, I always think of fresh fruit.
Watermelon.
Yes, watermelon, lemons, limes, you know, nice little spritzers on your French front porch. So so the colors I also were really attracted to were really bold colors, mixing two strong colors together. I think it's really eye-catching. I think it's fresh and vibrant, and I just think it's a nice way to kick off your summer. So it's always good to use nature, I think, for your color inspiration. And I thought this was really great. So you've got your grass greens and your teal and your yellows and like a peach and a watermelon, soft watermelon red. So then you transition that inspiration into maybe a linen set in a pink, or my favorite, the bold green with the pink on the bottom, or vice versa. So this is what I meant with the strong colors and pairing them together and just going for it. Take that risk. And so let's see, let's move over to this. Since we're talking about the grass green, we've got the grass green Hudson pants. I'm gonna take it off the wall here, with a teal cottage, which I think is really great. Both out of linen. I think that this is a great color combination. I think you can do a lot of different color combinations actually with these colors, because I think they're just really strong colors that look good on a lot of people. And like green, I think maybe you don't want to wear it on top, but I think you can wear those bold colors on the bottom if you're not comfortable with them near your face. So I think this is a great strong color combination. We were talking actually about this Hudson and like, what is the Hudson pant? We don't talk about it very often. Mm-hmm.
I was wondering, they seem similar to the Picasso when you look at it because of that, the tapered element that both the Hudson and the Picasso have. But I love these pants.
They're simple. They just have two darts in the front and two darts in the back, and a waist, or the elastic waist, all the way around. So they're a very quick sew, extremely flattering. They're not too slim, but they're also not a wide leg. So I think they look good with a lot of different tops because of that. So this is one of my favorite pants right now. So, because it's quick and easy.
Well, you're seeing on our wall a lot of like bold color statements, the white tops with the bold pant and pairing kind of different colors together. I love this one in the middle with the Madrid in linen, short sleeve with a wide leg West End,
yes.
Super fun.
Mm-hmm. I really like that color combination. The funny thing about some of these color combinations, you have to just start mixing them. You have to just start seeing what looks good together. Like, we didn't make these two with the intention of wearing them together, but mm-hmm. sometimes you just see these two colors together and it just mm-hmm. works. Mm-hmm. And go for it. You know, take it. Take the risk and go for it.
Yeah. And you've talked about the white shirt before, so we've got a white Nine Lives, which we're going to talk about here in a minute a little bit further. And also another West End in a bold red. Can't go wrong with a bold red. And this is like the silent sleeper over here. Erin pulled mm-hmm. this out yesterday. This is the Mimosa top. And this in a linen and this really pretty blue is amazing. I love this, especially for a summer top. And we've got it with a white Valencia.
Yeah, pair it with the crisp white. I think that's fantastic.
Yep.
And I think you could even put it with the green. What do you think about that?
Mm-hmm.
Another blue with the green. I love mm-hmm. the blue and green. Oh, I love that. Mm-hmm. Maybe even better.
I don't know.
I do.
Can it go with it all? Maybe.
I don't know about the blue and the red. That's a little too KU for me.
Well, Erin talked about the white shirt, which is also one of my favorites. And were there any other bits and pieces? You talked about white and color. So kind mm-hmm. of both of those together. A couple of my inspirations were hidden under here. I love, what should I talk about first? I love like the oversized shirt. What I'm wearing is the San Diego tunic.
Yes.
Thank you, Linda. You made this for me on your birthday, which seems so counterintuitive. She's literally the best mom ever. So this is in a lovely linen we have. It's like a salmon pink, kind of. Mm-hmm. Kind of a heathered pink, really pretty. And I love the oversized shirt. Another pattern I love is the Balboa. And we have, this pattern comes in two variations. One is shorter. This is the longer version in the pattern. Obviously, this is big, But wearing it over something, even this color combination is really pretty, but wearing it over something and then wearing it with like a skinny jean doesn't have to make it so large, but I love this color. I love it in a bold, bold color. Ever since I saw one of my favorite celebrities, Hailey Bieber, she wore exactly this color, basically exactly this pattern. She wore it basically as a dress, but with like a short underneath. So she showed her legs and all of that. I just was like, that's so fun. And it was the same color in the short. So even putting the same color on top and bottom, which you talked about too with your pink.
I remember when I went to Copenhagen a couple years ago, they were starting to do that with the large oversized shirts that might have come down to the knee or maybe a little bit shorter, and then wearing like an unexpected like leopard print short or something like that. And I loved it, and I'm not a big shorts fan, but just it was really hot that year, like hot for Copenhagen, and they have no air conditioning. And so everybody was in just trying to keep cool, let's just say that. But it was a really cute look. I mean, it was linen and cotton tops, you know, oversized, just like the Balboa with shorts. So
you can't go wrong with a great linen shirt. And we have so many shirt styles. Here's an inspiration, kind of that monochromatic color tone. So a white linen top. Again, you could. I thought about putting the San Diego tunic in a white. That would be beautiful. The Balboa in a white. We've got the Nine Lives in a white back here. But any of these tops in a crisp white, let it wrinkle. I've worn this shirt for 3 hours and I've already ironed it once. And
just go with it.
You know, yeah, you just go with it. You sit in your car, it's kind of wrinkly at the bottom, but
yeah, like you could do.
It's what you do.
If you're gonna do whites together, you know, you could do the Nine Lives with the Valencia or the Hudson or the West Ends, just all one color.
We're seeing a lot in that summer trend right now of linen sets, linen suits. So a wide leg pant with a crisp button down shirt, or even a blazer. So you get like a linen blazer to think about too. Here's another one in an all white version. So grab those West End pants and grab a button down shirt and make them all the same fabric. We've got one of my favorite patterns of a button down shirt is the Sienna. So here is the Sienna shirt in a great white linen, as classic as can be. And like Erin said, pairing it with a white, but pairing it with any of these pants.
Oh, definitely. I like having multiple white shirts this time of year because they're so easy to grab and then you can put them with any pant. I mean, they go with any pant. So I think they're a staple in your wardrobe, and a knit and a linen, you know, get them in a variety of different fabrics and silhouettes. And I think they're really easy pieces to incorporate into your wardrobe.
These are the Picassos, right? Those. We were talking about the difference between the Hudson and the Picassos. So this is a great pink color. And this is
Mix a tank.
But like this together, linen on linen, making it a tank top. Even what Betsy said, like her shirt in a woven, make it in a great woven as a shirt. Be great.
And keep those Picassos out. Remember, we were playing with this combination of color. Keep in mind, color. We were putting this pink linen, which we have, with this chartreuse linen and the magenta tank underneath. And while you might not do the Balboa with the Picasso, we tried that. It was not successful. But I think, you know, you could pair it with maybe a full-length Valencia or a Hudson. I think keep the pant at ankle length or longer, wouldn't you say, and more of a slimming silhouette.
Yeah.
But the colors are fantastic.
And I'm wearing a light gray Helix pant. So these are a skinny pant with this kind of larger pink oversized shirt. So think of a skinny version with a bigger shirt if you'd like to, with the Balboa, with you know, we've got the Florence is a great,
that's great because you could shorten, if you want to do it for summer, you could shorten the sleeves of the Florence, and that'd be really cute. Cut out some of the details even to make it simple, but the silhouette's there. So What's next?
So, Betsy, would you like to hand me the iPad? Unless there are any questions we can answer based on what Erin and I talked about.
Do you want to do questions?
Sure, we can do a few. Sure, why not? Mix it up a little bit. We'll do questions throughout the program.
We can do whatever we want since Linda's gone.
She's watching.
Oh, okay. Hello.
Okay, Erin, recap your dress. What kind of knit and what kind of dress?
Okay, so the question was about my Memphis dress. So the details are I used a white French terry, which we do have, and then a white linen. And I think you can mix where you put the knit versus the linen. I have pretty broad shoulders, so I wanted to keep the knit up here in my bust area and in my shoulder area just to give me some room to move. So that's what I decided to do, and I just think it's comfortable that way. But I do kind of wish I would have mixed the linen up a little bit in the front, done, you know, linen on one side and knit on the other. But so I think you can really play with that. And I lengthened it. I lengthened it 5 inches.
Did you, when you sized up, adjust the shoulders?
I did not, but I should have, and that was a good lesson for me. Repeat the question, sorry. So when I sized up, I did size up for the Memphis dress because I wanted it to be a little looser, and the question was, did I adjust the shoulder? I did not, and I regret that. So I do want to make another one because I think it's really fun. And so the next one, I'm going to adjust the shoulders. I had no idea that I would need to. I mean, that was my fault. But I have to adjust shoulders on everything, so I figured, it'll be fine. But lesson learned.
Someone wanted to know, is my shirt tied? And it is.
Oh.
Yes, Betsy's shirt is tied in the top of her skirt.
Yes.
So cute.
I love that look when you tie your t-shirts.
There's like a whole technique to it, too. There's like a whole way to do it, which I'm sure Betsy could do her own little video of how to.
I use hair ties.
Oh,
like
nice.
Those really thin, invisible hair ties, those really small ones.
Yeah. Oh.
This is what I do.
Great.
Someone wanted to know about linen being wrinkly, and people noted that the more you wash, the less it wrinkles, and also if you put it in the dryer.
So the wrinkles of linen. There we go. Erin, tell us.
Okay. Yes. So we do recommend talking about the wrinkles of the linen. That was what the question was. And we do recommend that you wash and dry it for a little while, but then hang it to dry. I know I do that when I wash things in general. I like to wash it and then dry it and then for a little bit, and then I hang it up and maybe spritz it with a little bit of water to get some extra wrinkles out. And it is going to wrinkle as you wear it, but I think embrace it. Embrace the wrinkles.
And when I was pressing these yesterday for today, I used maybe a little bit of starch spray or linen spray, depending on the garment. Not on all of these garments, but I remember I even said to Erin, like, before I pressed it, I was like, I don't really like pressing linen. But then I was doing it, and I was like, wait, this is actually really, it's very satisfying. But they are, and someone made a comment earlier how kind of clean they look right now. And, I mean, like I said, I pressed this right before we came on, and it's probably already a little bit gathered in places a bit. But there is this,
good.
The saying goes, you know, embrace the wrinkle and don't worry about it too much. Which I think is so true.
Mm-hmm. And I think our washed linen, though, has such a great drape. I don't find that because I've worn these West End pants, quite often. And yes, it is more wrinkled when you wear them than they look right now. But I don't feel frumpy when I wear them. I still feel nice and cool and elegant when I wear them. So I think you just know that it's going to happen, but I don't think it takes away from the beauty of what you make.
Can you add sleeves to the mimosa?
Can we add sleeves to the mimosa?
I'm trying to think if we've had any customers, and maybe you guys can chime in if you've tried it. I've never personally tried it. I think what I would do instead is maybe wear a little t-shirt underneath it. And to be honest, when it's hot, sometimes you just gotta have a tank top. You gotta have something sleeveless.
keep yourself cool. So, but maybe some customers have had some experience with that. Let us know if you have.
Can we see the Peach West End? And then we need to talk about short set on the mannequins.
Oh, that's true. Peach West Ends. I want to see those. This is out of the washed linen. Betsy, do you remember the color exactly? What the?
Is that cantaloupe?
Yes. Yes, this is cantaloupe. So we had this in stock last year, and we loved it so much, we got some more in this year. And I just think it's a great spring, summer color.
And so, we're gonna get to this little guy in a bit. We have a tutorial on sale today regarding the Nine Lives, which is the pattern that's on this mannequin. And we didn't also talk about making the West Ends into shorts, which is what is on the mannequin.
Should we just bring it out?
Yeah, let's bring it out.
For it?
So, of course, these West Ends are kind of a cropped, very wide leg pant, but hack them off even more, and they're a great short. So that's what's pictured here. That was also some of my inspiration that you saw in some of these photos, but putting a button-down shirt with like a linen short. Very trendy right now. Erin and I walked into a store recently. We both noticed how like a linen short was like all the rage right now. So if you need a short, think about making the West End into a short.
And you can make it whatever length you're comfortable with, which I think is nice, and still keeps you cool. I know sometimes we get questions about golf shorts. I think this is a great option for that. And pair it with our Nine Lives. So our Nine Lives pattern, ready for the drum roll?
Yeah. Hand me the iPad, Betsy.
So the Nine Lives is a pattern that we had, a printed pattern that we used to have, and it was very popular. So we decided that it needed to be a digital pattern. So we are debuting this Nine Lives today as a digital pattern. And there is also a really great tutorial to go with it, a So Confident tutorial.
There is.
So we're going to show you a little bit about the tutorial, and that has to do with the Nine Lives.
Yeah, so on our website, you'll see we have on our homepage, if you click on the first box, you're gonna take 25% off all solid linen today with the code. But in that folder, in that category, there is the tutorial. So this is the Sewing with Linen download file. It's $16.15 today, normally $18.99. So when you click on that, you'll purchase that. It'll go into your account. And when you purchase that tutorial, you'll get a download file in your account. And we're showing it on my iPad today just for you guys to know. If you have a device like an iPad, an iPhone, a computer, these files come to you digitally.
Mm-hmm. Where do they open it up, Alex? When they have an iPad, because I think a lot of our customers have iPads, where does the file go when they download it?
So it goes into your account. So would you like to tell us a little bit about accounts, Erin?
Where does it go?
Like on your iPad, where do you open up the file? Or does it automatically open up? Because we get that question a lot.
Well,
like, does it go to the iBooks or does it go to? I know in certain versions of iPads it goes to the iBooks, and sometimes it also just comes up on your browser, like where your internet. So I just didn't know, being the avid iPad user.
I'm trying to think of how it popped up. it came so naturally.
Let's see. Over here.
I'm gonna go here.
Let me go back. So doesn't it pop up here? Isn't that your downloads?
Yes. So when this came up, I saved it a certain place. So when it popped up in when that file was purchased, I see the download file in my account and I can click on it, and it can it pops up, I think, like you said, in a browser if you're on a website like a Safari or a Chrome or a Firefox. But if I wanted to save it to my computer so I had it forever and ever, then it'll if I hold it down, I can say...
A little square with an arrow on the top.
Yes, then I can say to save it to my files. save it to my desktop. Maybe you have like a sewing workshop tutorial folder somewhere and you save it in there. So then it's always kind of in your folder on your device, wherever you want to save it. But it will always be in your account. So you can always log into your account at sewingworkshop.com with your username and password, and then have that file in there. So if you ever lose it, don't fret. It will be in your account.
Right. So we just wanted to show you briefly what the tutorial looks like. Just kind of take advantage of having the iPad here so you could see it. Betsy, is that...
Can they get a little closer?
A little closer? Okay. Mm-hmm. All right. So so Sewing with Linen, it's a really extensive, great tutorial. It goes through learning about linen, some of the things we've talked about today. Then it also talks about notions that you need to work with linen. Of course, fusee web, which is essential in any sewing task. And a few other, pins and certain shears that you need and pressing tools. Which are very essential. The tailor's ham is just, couldn't have made this dress without a tailor's ham. I love a good tailor's ham. And the thread, of course, you want cotton thread when you're working with linen. And just different things, all the notions that you would need. And then it also goes through the nine lives. It talks about if you want to lengthen the nine lives pattern, it talks about how to do that. And then it goes through step by step how to make the nine lives. It starts at the very beginning, teaches you how to make tailor tacks, which is really essential for all the markings, and and then takes you through everything from interfacing to inserting the collar. And then I did want to point out, so let's bring this gal up here.
Bring her over.
So it also talks about a few other details on things you can do to embellish the nine lies. The nine lies, it's a very simple pattern, which is great, especially for, we're talking about simple, basic solids and that sort of thing, which is what we've been attracted to. But if you wanted to add some detail, I'm thinking Betsy here, we were very simple and then Betsy very detailed. So if you wanted to add detail, you could add it by adding these bias strips in a contrasting fabric, also linen, and then doing some machine embroidery on it. And so the tutorial goes through that as well. So not only can you make a simple basic nine lives vest, but you can also do an embellished version. So it goes through that as well. So it's very extensive. It's a really great tutorial to add to your sewing library. So,
This garment, like you said, really easy to make. You're not really having to worry about a sleeve. It's a nice way to think about making a collar if you're kind of new to some of those techniques. So,
All right. Great. So what is next on our little itinerary?
Are there any questions from anyone about the nine lives?
Switch.
What year so confident is the nine lives?
It's in the very, yes, the, so the Nine Lives tutorial is one of the first tutorials that we did, so it's in series one. So if you have series one, then you already have that tutorial.
Is the stripes on the Nine Lives ribbon?
No, but you could use ribbon. I mean, that's a great idea, but this is actually, it's linen that has been cut on the bias and then applied to the shirt. Okay, let's see. We do have a small. I could put it. Hey, actually, this kind of coordinates here. And I, so we're gonna put on a nine live. And actually, this is a great top to wear as like a little jacket. Mm-hmm. To wear as a summer jacket. Maybe you go places where it's air conditioned, like offices, like ours, which is freezing. So. So you could just have something, an extra layer to throw on, too, so.
Does your white need to be lined?
So I was actually thinking about that. I don't think it
needs...
Oh, sorry. Terrible at that. Okay, so repeating the question. Does my white need to be lined? No. I think in every day I would not have a lining or have a slip. I did wear a slip today to be completely honest, because who knows what would happen on camera, and that could be quite embarrassing. So I didn't want to have any snafus. But no, I did try it on at home without a slip, and I was quite comfortable.
Can you turn around and show us the back of the nine plies?
Yes. So it's an asymmetric top. So the right side seam is higher than the left side seam. So it angles down.
Can you make shorts with the Hudson pants?
You could make shorts with the Hudson pants. Mm-hmm. So that was the question. Can you make shorts with the Hudson pants? And yes. I'm trying to think of a pants pattern where you can't. I mean, even if you could even do the Picasso, even though you would be cutting off details, but you could make shorts out of any pants pattern.
Didn't you make shorts out of the Valencia?
Yes, I did. I did make shorts out of the Valencia. Mm-hmm.
What is the trim on the white nine lies? You might need to come close.
Okay. So it's the same technique on this white nine lives. So it is bias strips of linen, and then it's embellished with red thread. So.
What is the green shirt on the back wall? Which must be Madrid.
This one? This is like a mint green.
But it's the Madrid.
It is the Madrid pattern, yes. In the pattern, the pattern is long sleeves, but this is short sleeves. And was there any other alteration? I think it was just made in a linen or woven. So
Linda made this. I think she lengthened it. She tends to lengthen this pattern. So if I were to guess, she lengthened it 2 inches. If she's on, maybe she can pipe in and say what she actually did. But she does typically lengthen it, and it does look lengthened. So, but great in this linen. I love that.
We have a couple questions about the different weights of linen. We have a lot of mid-weight linen, but I'm guessing that turquoise and my pants are lightweight, but they should say on the website.
Okay, so the question was about different weights of linen and maybe what we have. And so we do have a variety of different weights of linen, and it says it in the description and in the title of the linen fabric products. As far as what we have here, we have, these are both a medium weight linen. These two are, and these two are also medium weight linen. This one is a lighter weight linen, and this one's the medium weight washed linen. Medium weight here in the red. This white is also medium weight. This blue seems a little bit lighter than our washed medium weight. And same with, this is more of a medium weight. I like medium weight in white linen. I don't know about, just gives it a little extra thickness, I think. And you said what, this is medium weight.
That's medium weight, but my Weston pants are lightweight.
Oh, these.
Yeah.
Okay, so Betsy's West Ends are a lightweight linen. But most of the pieces we have that we've shown you are medium weight. So, like your top,
medium weight. Medium weight as well.
Linda said 1 inch right side only.
Okay, so Linda, she did lengthen her Madrid top right side only, and she only lengthened it 1 inch. So.
Are the bias strips on the nine lines?
Yes, the bias strips on the nine lives are raw edge. So since you're cutting it on the bias, you can leave those edges raw.
And that's not something that's included in the pattern, like how to make. That's just an embellishment from the tutorial.
Right, so if you want to learn how to do these strips and these embellishments, that's what's in the tutorial, correct?
In the pattern, it's just the basic shirt. It's just something to add yourself if you'd like.
Right.
Someone asked about the color of the Balboa shirt. We don't have that particular fabric, but I'm sure we have a chartreuse or citrus, very similar.
Okay, do we want to link to that specific color? The question was about the color of this Balboa and whether we have this color. We don't have this exact color, but we have some similar colors. We have, what do we decide? We had over 70
solid linens?
Over 70, yes.
So there's a variety of colors for, you know, all your color needs. So so there's quite a selection of different colors.
Maybe reinforce the fact that the pattern's already marked down, but the linen needs a coat.
Yes, we haven't really actually gone through the extent of the sale, so I think maybe we should start in on that.
Yeah.
Do we want to do that?
Sure. Okay. Yes. So today...
Wait, is there a drum roll? Or
there should be a drum roll, ladies. Let's do this. The code you're going to use today is linen21. So that's 25% off all solid linen. It's all in that category like we showed you on the homepage. Click that home screen button that says... It says the code on that image as well. We can show that again here. So you're going to go to that, and the category is called Color Me Linen, and it's all that is available and on sale is listed under there. So
yes,
Erin can go up there.
So if you even have the code listed here on the image, so on our homepage, this beautiful picture of Linda in the Nine Lives has the code, and you just tap on that, maybe a little bit more forceful.
Give it a good one.
And oh, it's the internet. It's our internet. And then that lists everything that's on sale. Our patterns are already marked down. So those are the ones that are on sale or listed in that category. And then it also lists the tutorial that's on sale and all the solid linens.
And that code can't be used with any other offers or promotions. So... just use linen21, and that's your 25% off.
And then we want to make sure and go through the patterns that are on sale. So we do have certain patterns that are on sale this week, but a great variety. So of course, our debut of the Nine Lives is in there, and then I'm going to take this list here. So the mimosa is on sale this week. Isn't that beautiful? I want to wear that. I'm going to have to snag that. The 1111 skirt, which is what Betsy has on. The Madrid. Beautiful Madrid. That is a pattern that we should pay more attention to.
I know.
It's beautiful.
Also as a little sleeper, and it's great
is.
Though.
It is.
Short sleeve, woven, knit.
San Diego. So the San Diego pattern is also one we haven't talked about in a while. So the San Diego is great because it has a tunic, it has a top, which is the same style, but it's just shorter. And then it has the original San Diego jacket pattern. So
three in one.
It's great.
Yeah.
Great, great. The Memphis, so that's the dress that I have on. And the Splice, and that's the dress that Betsy made. The Splice is a top. But she lengthened it into a dress or a tunic. And then the Nine Lives. So those are the patterns that are on sale this week, plus the Sewing with Linen tutorial that we talked about, and all the solid linens, 25% off. Mm-hmm. So, you
and
know.
How long does this go till?
Goes till next Monday. So, and so yeah, 25% off. The code is linen21. So you need to enter that. Let's do that. Should we?
Let's do it.
We should do that. We should do that. Okay.
I want the cantaloupe linen.
You want the
cantaloupe? Can we do that?
Okay. So Alex wants the cantaloupe linen. I'm going to have to find that. She's so picky. So picky.
All right. If you can't pick cantaloupe, pick your next favorite.
Linen, medium weight citrus. That kind of
citrus works.
Let's do that. Because that you could do that for your Balboa. Okay, so we're gonna buy medium weight citrus. We are going to get a yard. And we do have thread, if you didn't know about that feature. So I'm gonna add one spool of thread here. I'm gonna add that to my bag. Then I'm gonna open my bag. And so over here on the side, you have your shopping cart, and it lists everything that you are going to purchase. And then right underneath your total, there's a section that says redeem your code. So we're gonna tap on that. And then that's when you enter the linen21. I'm gonna try and do this without dropping the iPad. And then we click apply. Make sure you hit apply.
And then it'll have a little check mark so you know it worked. Always check and make sure that the discount's applied and make sure what you want is in your cart and there's no little snafus going on. And then you check out. So that's how you get your 25% off the linens. Any other questions or anything else we want to chat about?
One more question, which was how to shorten the sleeves on the Madrid.
So on the Madrid, and I think on any sleeve that you want to shorten, so we're shortening the sleeve on the Madrid. So you want to find the length that you want. You want to, maybe you have another shirt that you like the length of the sleeve. And so find out that length, and you want to measure from the dot of the sleeve or your shoulder point down that length that you like, and then add the hem allowance and draw a perpendicular line from that measurement. And then you're going to want to take the sides of the sleeves and join the sides down to the bottom to your new measurement. And you might have to adjust the sides a little bit to accommodate folding in the hem. But there's got to be a tutorial on how to do this. Where would we find that? Maybe we'll post a link, and that way you guys can have a visual. I know I'm a visual learner, so we'll post a link to whether it's a blog or whether it's a tutorial that you might be interested in on the best way to change the length of a sleeve. How's that sound? Okay, let's do that.
All right. We've shown you a lot of things today, guys. Inspirations from three people.
Summer inspirations.
Summer linen, color me linen, the tutorial, how to use your account, how to download the files. So hope you guys had fun. Thanks for joining the party.
All right. Thank you.